Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you.
Amen. So
I notice the family of God has gathered together, so you're very welcome. Today is Ash Wednesday, it's also the first day of Lent, and Lent is like a journey leading through various stages to the joy of Easter. So let's kneel down and ask the Lord to start us.
Repents of evil. Who knows? Zion. Sanctify the fast. Call a solemn assembly. Gather the people. Sanctify the congregation. Assemble the elders. Gather the children, even the nursing infants. Let the bridegroom leave his room, and the bride her chamber. Between the vestibule and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep and say, spare your people, O Lord, and make not your heritage a reproach, a byword among the nations. Why should they say among the peoples, where is their God? Then the Lord became jealous of his land and had pity on his people. The word of the Lord. Our responsorial psalm, have mercy, O Lord, for we have sinned. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your merciful love. According to your great compassion, blot out my transgressions. Wash me completely from the iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Have mercy, O Lord, for I am a sinner. My transgressions, truly I know them. In sin is always before me. Against you, you alone I have sinned. What is evil in your sight I have done.
Have mercy, O Lord, for I have sinned.
Create a pure heart for me, O God. Renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence. Take not your Holy Spirit from me.
Have mercy,
restore in me the joy of your salvation. Sustain in me a willing spirit. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Give alms. Sound no trumpet before you, as as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may be praised by men. Truly I say to you, they have had their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be in secret, and your Father who sees in secret what you do will reward you. And when you pray, you must not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, that they may be seen by men. Truly I say to you, they have had their reward. But when you pray, go into your room, shut the door, and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And when you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces, that their fasting may be seen by men. Truly I say to you, they have had their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, that your fasting may not be seen by men, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. The Gospel of the Lord. Amen.
Good evening and welcome again to this wonderful gathering of the faith community. It's Ash Wednesday, the first day of Lent. Lent is 40 days, versus Jesus was 40 days in the desert, and the Israelites in the journey were 40 years. So it's a very symbolic time. Some people ask, Lent isn't really kind of sad time, giving up sweets, giving up alcohol? Is it a very sad time going to confession? Or is it a very joyful time? Well, maybe a bit of both. I like to put it, it's the season of joyful return. Return to God, return to ourselves, return to our family life. And the Gospel has given us some suggestions how to make that return. So, welcome to the journey. Remember, today is part of a longer journey. 40 days, 6 weeks in Lent, coming into Holy Week, Holy Thursday, the washing of feet, Good Friday again, we'll hear a great one. And then please come on Holy Saturday. Now, this is the climax, Holy Saturday night, so don't miss that. Easter, that's the whole point. So we're on a journey, leaving the old, leaving the Egypt, leaving the slavery into the freedom of the sons and daughters of God, which is Easter Sunday. So let's keep that journey on. So, we mentioned the sacrament of reconciliation, and the Gospel recommends three things: prayer, fasting, and alms-giving. So, I'll try to reflect briefly on all three. Prayer is certainly a time to, have a little bit more prayer. Jesus says, when you pray, go into your private room, so close the door like that, and then pray. Might be switch off the phone, such as switch off the TV. Have some downtime. People in Lusaka, as in other cities, are very busy people, traveling to work, traveling back, kicking up queues. So we're always on the move. So sometimes when we stop, we get nervous. So downtime can be very, very healthy and very, very enjoyable. There's so many ways to do it. It can be done just breathing, yoga style, breathing. Be still and know that I'm not. How long? 5 minutes? 20 minutes? Whatever you're comfortable with. Some people are anxious, Well, if you're aware of the anxiety, say, I am feeling anxious, and give yourself 5 more minutes of music. So don't give up at the first sign of anxiety. Be still and know that I'm not. Downtime. Because then, Catholic faith, Christian faith, all to do with God. So prayer, personal prayer, is a great way of meeting God. Of course, there's daily mass in the morning here, 6:30, and in the evening, 7:30, Wednesdays, at 30 mass. So mass, some people say, I go to mass every day during the week. That's another form of prayer. Prayer with the scripture, People often say to me that just one word during Mass, one word was enough to change their life. Listen attention to the word in the church or at home with the Bible. Let that one word sink in. Another way to pray is at the end of the day. This is from St. Ignatius of Loyola. Just look back over the day. We have a cameraman here. Look back, use your imaginary video. Look back over the day and notice what happened. Remember what happened in that song. Especially something that's unexpected. And notice how our God is not hidden away somewhere, he's quite active in the day. But you won't notice it unless you pray or for the example. So 5-10 minutes, look back over the day and notice. Not looking for your sins and your faults, but looking for what God, the gifts that God gave you, your family, the food, the work, the day went well, you met a friend. So there are some suggestions for prayer. Second one, prayer, fasting. Fasting normally we think of giving up food. I mentioned alcohol already. That's one of my jobs, as you know. What else could we fast for? Some people tell me, Father, in our family we're very short-tempered. Could that be something we could give up? Other people tell me, some people think we work too much. We are really a young family, we have to work hard to make ends meet. But if we're working too much, what's the point of spending hours in the evening working and children and spouse neglected? So maybe give up some of it. Do you need all of it? So this is proposing prayer fasting. I won't mention other things you might fast from, but I think we all know what you might fast from. Yeah? Just give you some safe examples. Prayer, fasting, almsgiving, concern for the neighbor. If you're married, your first neighbor is your spouse. If you're married in family, your spouse and your children. It's the same point. Give prime time to family in the evening. I like clubbing. So this is the time for Lent, the joyful return of your Father. Wouldn't it be great at Easter to say, I have 6 wonderful weeks of Lent. Happy, joyful family weeks. We have family outing this and that. Again, so a joyful time coming back to God. I mentioned before the sacrament of reconciliation. It would be wonderful if everyone in the church today came back to the sacrament confession, reconciliation. And that has such a wider meaning because the sacrament of reconciliation means the church around the world is concerned about the war in Ukraine and in Eastern Congo and in Yemen and other places, in Israel, even Jerusalem. So we are a people of reconciliation as we heard in the first week, the second week. So when we reconcile with our God on our legend journey, reconcile with each other, we also pray for peace and reconciliation around the world. Some of us, that might be enough for almsgiving. For some of us, it means maybe working in a more responsible way. So some people, I don't work in the private or in the public sector, but some people say those at the top work very hard, those at the bottom work extremely hard, but the middle management sometimes a bit. So apply that to you if it fits. But if we're working responsibly as Lusaka residents, then that might be the best contribution to almsgiving. Other ways of almsgiving is through kids. There are lots of schools for orphan kids. You might want to pick up on one of those. There's so many other charities, prisons, etc. So the program is clear, the journey has begun, we're on retreat, this is a 40-day retreat, so welcome. And I hope and pray that we all use the 40 days well. In a moment you see the ashes, which is saying, I want ashes of death. Death to sin and all those terrible things that you might have done. and then open to new life. And the words the priest would say, repent and believe in the good news. Repent of your sins and believe in the good news. So the actions are very blessed. I just say a prayer of thanks for the ashes, and then we'll start the giving of the ashes.
God, our Father, you are moved by acts of humility. You respond with forgiveness to our works of penance. Father, we ask you to hear our prayers, and we thank you for these ashes that have been blessed. As we place these ashes on your servants, who are marked on the sign of the cross, and as they follow the tree of observances of Lent, may they be worthy to come with minds made pure, to celebrate the Easter mystery of your Son. We make our prayer through Christ your Lord.
Thank you.
journey from death, from sin, to the joy of Easter. As we pray, please pray that this, our sacrifice, may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Pat Southward and Alec Abishman, and all the clergy.
Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints that have pleased you throughout the ages,
Jesus was a man of prayer, and he tells us, when you pray, pray like this. Our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.